Hello guys. Hi, my name is Vikas, Vikas Sharma. I am a senior counselor and operation manager at Education Street. Today we are conducting an online session for all the students who aspire to go abroad to study in Australia. However, we have planned to follow a particular agenda today. As it's a broad topic, we would try to answer all the queries that you might have before you start searching your universities or considering Australia as one of the options to study abroad. We are here to answer all your queries. I hope I am audible to all. If there is any queries that you have in between the session, you can post a comment and I will take care of the query. And I will try to give you all the unbiased information that you require. And I hope you have all the information required before you decide Australia as one of your choice to go abroad and make your career out there. So today's session will start with the basic thing, why Australia is a good option to study abroad. Firstly, I would say, going with the masses, I would say it's the third most popular destination for Indian students or international students to study abroad. On an average, an approximate more than 5 lakh international students, out of which around a lakh Indian students go to Australia every year for their higher studies. There is a good amount of rise, I would say, around more than 14% to 20% rise in the number of applications received by Australian university this year. So the popularity of Australian as a destination for study abroad is growing day by day. Secondly, I would say it's a stable economy. Third, I would say it's one of the wealthiest country in terms of per capita or per person income. It's one of the wealthiest country. You can search it on Google or Wikipedia about the same. Given the fact that the universities that you have in Australia are very good, their education system is particularly precise with what they teach. For example, if you want to go for a course in a course of engineering, so you get a good specialized courses in Australian universities. Considering the education part, Australian is one of the country where you are 15 year of education is accepted. Now, what is 15 year of education? It's 12 plus 3 for especially for the Indian people who have done BCom, BA or the courses which are 12 plus 3. It becomes a problem for them to go to US, because there are not many universities. However, they have started, but not many university would accept your 15 year of education. Australia will welcome you all with 15 year of education or with 16 year of education. Australian universities are top 8 universities of Australia's are among top 100 in the world. So that also gives you a good exposure to brand name as well, so that you don't have to complain about the name of the university, whether it would be recognized or not. So let me tell you, Australian universities or Australian education is recognized across the globe. So you won't find any problem related to that. So you don't have to worry about whether my education would be valid when I come back to India after getting some work experience. Talking about Australia again, the population is decent enough. Not the unemployment ratio is in the range of 5 to 6%, which is again a good number to achieve. So this is why Australia gives you a good option. Top livable cities: Melbourne, Sydney, Perth, Brisbane, Canberra. They are most welcoming cities of Australia for international students. So this is why Australia gives you a good opportunity to work, to study, to work, and maybe in future to settle down in Australia as well. So this is just to give you an overview what Australia is all about. Let us talk about Australia as an education study overseas education destination. When it comes to Australia, let us first understand the basic factors. Let us talk about the intake first. Australia generally has two major intake, which is one is in July, one is in Feb every year, and there is a very minor intake of November. However, it's not that big. Not all universities are open. Very few are open for very few courses. To make sure that you have the proper time in hand, the general deadline for all the application, you should start by around in 6 months prior to your course start date. So if you go for July intake, the ideal time to start is Jan and Feb. Talking about the tuition cost, Tuition cost, however, in Australia varies depending upon universities or university to university. Let us first talk about university. I'm so sorry. In Australia, you have group of eight. Not is group of eight. Many people do have this doubt. So group of eight is a collaboration of eight universities, which are top eight universities of Australia. They are also among top 100, top 200 in the world. And some of the program are among top 30 in the world as well. So that gives you a good advantage if you get selected to those kind of those universities. It gives you a good exposure. Apart from the group of eight, there are a good amount of universities that you have, which an international student can apply and can study over there. On an average, there are around 40 to 43 universities in Australia where an international student can apply. You have to make sure before you apply to a particular course, you should check whether that particular course is available for international students or not. Talking about the tuition cost, if I talk about group of eight, as they are top eight universities, they are generally expensive in terms of their tuition cost. So they generally range around 16 to 18 lakhs rupees on an average. The other non-group of eight would cost you approximately 14 to 16 lakhs, 12 lakhs, 13 lakhs. It varies a lot depending upon which university and which area do we go. The living cost, generally we spend around 6 to 7 lakh rupees, I would say, per year. However, the show cost, when I say show cost, it is according to their defined living cost by the Department of Immigration and Border Protection, which is called as DIBP. So they define an amount of approximately 20,290 Australian dollars as your living cost. So you have to declare these financials for your living. However, the spending cost is totally different. Now, normally what happens, you are once your course starts, you are entitled to work part-time on or off campus. That gives you a pretty good amount of time to earn good amount of money in terms of your living cost. Australia is one of the highest wage paying country. On an average, you can see a person, a master student especially, can earn approximately $18 to $25 per hour, and 20 hours is what you are allowed to work. Giving you a rough calculation of $20 per hour and 20 hours a week, you can approximately make around $400 per week, which gives you approximately $1,600 per month, which is more than sufficient for you to take care of your living cost. However, you should have your funds available with you in case if you don't get a part-time job, which has hardly happened with any of our student or in our entire experience sending student across in Australia. Now, talking about Australia as a whole, let us talk about the entry requirement. Now, basically, entry requirement for the group of eight, as they are top eight universities, the general requirement is about 60%. But some of the engineering courses, advanced engineering courses, and other courses related to law or medical, they require higher percentage. On an advanced engineering course, you would require at least 65% and above. For any business related program, you would require at least 60% and above. Non-G8 universities might require approximately from 55% to 60%. Australia also gives you an option if your percentage requirement is not meeting the entry requirement. There are some universities which provide pathway options to you. Now, this pathway options, it's a kind of a diploma that you do in addition to your master's. And those diploma credits get transferred to your master's. That means your course duration still remains the same. However, you get a different entry point to the master's program. This is only for the people who have low percentage if they're not meeting the academic requirement of a particular university. There are also MQP programs, which are called as master qualifying programs. These are separated from pathway programs. Master qualifying programs are the one wherein you go for an additional 6 month course for before your master starts. So that means if your master is for 2 years, you go for a 6 month MQP, which is master qualifying program. Your course becomes 2.5 years. Obviously, the cost would be more. But if you want to enter the university, and if you're not meeting the academic requirement, this is one of the ways that you can enter. However, it is not available with all the university. You need to check it with the university in which you are applying. Next is the test requirement. Generally, the test is only an IELTS test, which is an English proficiency test. When I speak of English proficiency, it can be an IELTS, TOEFL, or PTE. All three are widely acceptable with all the universities. General requirement of 6.5 with no band less than 6 in IELTS and equivalent score in TOEFL and PTE, which you can check it on Google if you want. So that is the test requirement. However, again, Australia gives you an advantage if you're not meeting the IELTS requirement. There are certain universities, majorly I would say all the university provides you an LE course program, which is an English language course. It is generally for 12 weeks and even lesser if your score is good enough. So 12 weeks program, your course starts 3 to 4 months prior to your master course, and you go there, you complete your English language course, and then post successful completion of your LE course, you enter your master's program. However, this also would cost you an extra, some extra dollars, but you can obviously, if you want to enter the Australian university, and if you're not able to meet the English requirement, then you can go and you can select this path as well. Talking about the course of study. Now, Australia, generally all the courses are available. You talk about engineering courses, you talk about management courses, you talk about financial courses, law courses, medical courses, and so on and so forth. However, when it comes to engineering courses, it's a very straightforward application that you have to make. Same goes with the business applications. However, when it comes to medical and law related courses, the entry requirement are a bit different. So we need to check, you need to check it before you apply to any particular university. Now, the course of duration of the courses normally is for 2 years. Now, when I say 2 years, it is not mandatorily 2 years, but for an international student to have post study work visa, you have to make sure that you go for a course which is of 2 years. If you go for any course which is less than 2 years, that is 1 year or 1.5 years, you are not entitled to have the post study work visa. So you have to make sure that you apply for the proper course with proper duration, which is 2 years or more. Now, when it comes to bachelor's, normally the course duration is 3 to 4 years, 3 years for the people who want to go for management related courses, and for the people who wants to go for engineering related courses and medical related courses, the duration is for 4 years. When it comes to cost of education and living cost, however, we have already discussed that the cost of education is on an average, I would say it's ranging between 14 to 16 lakh per annum. That is an average cost considering all the university group of 8, non-group of 8. Living cost, as I mentioned, the living cost is 6 to 7 lakh rupees a year. But to show the cost is different. Now, why Australia is, again, it's a very good question. Like once you go for higher studies abroad, you also hope to have some post-study work visas so that you can work post completion of your master's. So Australia has a very straightforward rule, which states that if you go for any master's course or a course which is for, or a bachelor's course which is for 3 years or 4 years for bachelor's or master's for 2 years, then you're entitled to have 2 years of post-study work visa. These 2 years are given straightforward to you. There is no conditions on this. Only condition is you have to complete your course of study. Once you complete, you get that post-study work visa and you're entitled to find job across Australia. Once you find your job, you work in that particular job and then you can apply for your work permits. Now, when it comes to Australia, you guys have, many of you, if you are interested to go abroad for higher studies in Australia, you must have heard about the Australian government abolishing the work visa. However, they have renewed it. Now they have displayed a list which is called as skilled occupation list. And if you go on their official website and you actually check the SOL list, you will find most of the courses which you go for or which an international student would go for, like engineering, management, finance, accounting, computer science, mechanical, you name the course and you would find the skill list would mention your course which is there. So you don't have to worry in that terms whether I would get an extension or not. You would get an extension. The extension would depend upon what kind of skills you have. The normal extension is for 1 year, then it can be extended to 2 years to 4 years. So don't worry about that. You have 2 years straight, and then later on you can extend your work visas depending upon which field you're working in. Talking about the job prospects, On an average, we have seen that the students who go for higher studies in Australia generally are placed within the period of 0 to 3 months after their course completion, which is a pretty decent time, I would say. There are a good number of internship opportunities are also available if you have work experience post prior to your commencement of your course. If you have, let us say, 2 years of experience, you can also apply for internship. Once you get into internship, obviously you can always convert that internship into a full-time job opportunity by working well during your internship. On an average, an engineering student or a graduate student in Australia are generally paid in a range of 65,000 to 85,000 Australian dollars, or above it if you're an MBA student with certain work experience in your profile, which gives you a pretty decent return on investment because you're spending that amount, I would say an amount of 80,000 for 2 years. You can easily get your return on investment within 2 years. So it's a safe play kind of thing, I would say, because you don't have to worry. Once placed into a company, obviously you have to showcase your skill. You have to work hard to maintain your reputation with the company as a good worker or a good skilled labor. And then you can extend your work visas and you can work for a longer period of time. Now, talking about the other aspect of Australia, which states that if the student are entitled, or the person is entitled also to apply for permanent residency. Now, what is permanent residency? Generally, it is given for 5 years. You have to collect some points. When I say collect some point, the PR system is based on points. We will not discuss much about PR because we are only here to for the study purpose. But just to give you an idea, the PR point, system is all based on points. The points are generally based on your age, your location of your stay, your job, relevancy of your job from your the course that you have studied, your past experience, your current experience in Australia and stuff like that. Calculating each and every point, if you fall under that threshold point value wherein you're entitled to apply for PR, you can obviously apply for PR and get your PR over there in Australia and stay back for next 5 years. So overall, just to conclude with this, there are certain myths that we have heard. People generally, when they come for inquiry with us at Education Street, generally they say that Australia is it's not safe. People feel they are racist and stuff like that. There is nothing like this that any of our student has been experienced or their students' friends have experienced. We have one of our student who have shared her experience with us, stating she has completed her master's in Australia and now she is currently working. So I would be putting that into a comment section. It's a blog written by her itself. So it's written by the student. So I would be posting it into a comment section. You can go there. You can check it. You can see what students face it in Australia. So it's a good experience that she has shared. So please go through that blog. I'll be posting that comment right now. So you can just follow that link and you can have a look at that blog. The email ID of the student is also given if you want to check the authenticity of the blog and stuff. So I've just posted it. You can check it once you get time. Now, talking about the overall scenario, the visa rejection ratios and stuff. A general deadline when you apply for, this is an overall idea I would like to conclude. When you think of applying to Australia, there are certain things which you should make sure. First, make your application with good amount of time in hand. Early applications with good academics will always, not always I would say, but there are strong chances that you would attract good amount of scholarship. We had good number of students this year who have received good amount of scholarship. The scholarship amount is going above $1 lakh or so. Second, make sure that you meet the test requirement, which is IELTS or English Proficiency Test. Meet the requirement properly with 6.5 with no band less than 6 for the masters and 6 with no band less than 5.5 for bachelors. However, there are courses in engineering, advanced engineering, which will require 6.5 with no band less than 6 in bachelors as well. Next, third thing, keep your financial documents properly arranged. Now, when I talk about financial documents, there are certain set of documents which you can, which you have to declare your financials. You have to showcase your financials. So for your financials, you can always show your saving bank account, which has to be 3 month old funds When I say 3 month old, it cannot be a fresh fund. You have to make sure that the funds are at least 3 months old. Then FDs, which again 3 months old, you can show a bank loan. So these are the basic documents which normally students use. Financials should be up to date. Your sponsor affidavit should be ready. And you apply your visa well in time. So once you get your offer letter, you declare your financials, you make your fee payment, and then you apply your visa well in time. However, Australian visa are quick nowadays because the process has entirely gone online. But we generally recommend students to have at least 4 to 5 weeks in hand before your course starts. So you make sure that your visa is applied on time so that you don't delay or you don't miss on any opportunity. So these are the basic points which you should consider before you apply. So check your university well, apply on time, try to get scholarship, keep your financial ready, keep your sponsor affidavit ready, and apply for your visa on time, at least 4 to 5 weeks prior to. Once your visa is there in your hand, you can fly off to Australia and you can complete your course and stay there for 2 years. That is a post-study work visa. You can apply for your work visa once you have your good job and your company sponsoring you. And then obviously you can apply for your PR if you're looking back. But once you come back to India, if you're coming back to India, I would say, then you don't have to worry about whether you would get the job or not. Obviously, when you come from a developed country, you have a high-end experience of the latest technology. When you come back to India, you would easily get placed in the top companies, most of the MNCs. So don't worry about whether when I'll come back, whether I'll have the validity of my degree and stuff like that. It's something which you should keep, you should totally throw out of your mind. It's absolutely valid. All your work experience would be counted and you would be well placed when you come back to India. And I would say you're highly, you would be placed in a high package. And just to end with, so we at Education Street, you can contact us. You can post your comments over here. If you have any queries, you can directly get in touch with us. I would be posting the address of our website. You can go in there. You can post your queries over there. You can put up your queries over there as well. You can go through our blogs. You can go through our website. So it will give you a clear idea about each and everything. If you have any queries, you can come for a one-to-one counseling session for your particular profile evaluation and stuff. We'll give you all the information required. We'll process all your application as required and we'll file your visa on your behalf. I hope some of your queries at least must have been solved, and we'll see you soon with the next session, a live session of different countries in the next week. Next Saturday we'll have again a new live session. So I hope you all join again with Education Street, and you can share these videos, share this video with your friends, and you can follow us on Facebook so that you get live updates and regular updates on our Facebook page. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time.